Now today we are going to start with the discussion of the question answers, but as per 10C class, as you have told ma'am, it was not done. So let me just revise the main point. So in the chapter starting, as you have read that Anne Frank was feeling lonely one day and she did not find anyone where to give a vent to her feelings. So this is the reason why she started writing a diary. This was gifted to her by her father on her 13th birthday, and she thought that paper has more patience than people, and this is the reason why she has started writing. She has also mentioned that it was not because that she did not have a loving father. Of course, she had a loving father, loving family, including in the family there were aunts and uncles, and moreover she said that she had number of friends, but she did not have any friend to confide in. So this is the reason why she thought to write a diary, and finally she has named her diary as Kitty. So later on the next day when she has gone to school, she has mentioned that Mr. Keating was her mathematics teacher, who was not at all so good with her. It is just because of the reason, because she is talking a lot in the class. She is always talking. She is a talkative girl. And ultimately, Mr. Keating did not like her talkative nature. This is the reason for the first time that Mr. Keating had given her an essay to be written on the topic Chatterbox. She had written an essay at home when she has gone. She had opened up the notebook and has pinned down all the arguments that would like to be presented. And she has noted there, she has mentioned in her arguments that it was the right of every child to talk in the class, and it is just because of her mother that she has inherited this trait of talking a lot from her mother, and this is the reason why she is talking a lot. Mr. Keating, he has read it. For next 2 periods, she was quiet in the class, but in the third class also again she started talking, and this made Mr. Keezing, he this made again Mr. Keezing annoyed, and what he did, he has again given her an essay to be written on an incorrigible chatterbox. Again, now she has presented it, she has written her arguments, but the third time when she was again talking in the class, then Mr. Keezing has given her an essay to be written on quack, 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 incorrigible chatterbox. So this time her friend San, who was good in writing, she has suggested her that she should help her to write an essay in the form of verse. Verse means in the form of a poem. And finally she has written a story about a duck and a swan who had three ducklings, and the duck, he has bitten all the three ducklings to death. It was because they were quacking all the time, they were talking all the time. So finally what has happened, so this was read by Mr. Keezing and he laughed a lot after reading it. Okay, so he laughed a lot and he has added some of his personal comments and has read it in the other classes too. So this is how the relationship between Anne and Mr. Keezing has improved a bit. Next, afterwards we are coming with the discussion of the question answers. So many students are still entering. I don't know why. Yes. Was Anne right? So let me share with you the screen. I can share with you the chapter so that you can have. So that you can have the idea of the question answers. Let us see this comprehension part. What makes writing in a diary? So many students are entering just now. I don't know why. Now you will be able to see. So here it is. Students are still entering the room. Now, What makes writing in a diary strange experience for Anne Frank? Why it was a strange experience for Anne Frank to write in a diary? Can anybody tell from 10th B? Just raise up your hand if anybody can. Bhumika, Bhavna. So she thought that writing in a diary, it was a strange experience for her, because she thought that, or as she thought that, she was too young to write. Okay, so 1 minute. Nishtha raised hand. Very good, Nishtha. Yes, you can give the answer. Yes, Nishtha.
Ma'am, writing in a diary was a strange experience for Anne Frank because she has never written a diary before. Moreover, for her, she thought that who will be interested in reading her diary.
Okay, right. Absolutely right. So what she thought that nobody will be interested in the musings of a 13-year-old girl because she is too young and nobody would like to read about the thoughts as well as the feelings of a 13-year-old girl. Moreover, she thought that people used to write down the important things in the diary, but she should write down her experiences and her feelings in the diary. And moreover, she has never written a diary, so she feels that it was really strange experience for her to write a diary. Next, why does Anne want to keep a diary? Why she decided to keep a diary? Now raise up your hand. Why does Anne decided to raise up a diary? Yes, Jasleen.
She was having a lot of friends, but she was not having a real friend. So she decided, so when her grandma gave her diary, she decided to make the diary her friend and wrote her feelings in the diary and share her feelings by writing in the diary.
Yes, because one day she was feeling too depressed. She did not know whether to stay in or to go out of the house. She did not find anyone to give a vent to her feelings, and she did not find anyone in order to share her feelings with. So finally, what she decided to write on a paper, and after writing on the paper her feelings, she felt quite relaxed, or she felt relaxed. And then she decided, and then she has come to know that paper has more patience than people. And finally, she also felt that she did not have any friends to confide in. And this is the reason why she started writing a diary. And she named her diary as Kitty. Okay. Next, why did Anne think she could confide more in her diary than in people? Why she thought she should confide in her diary more than in people? Yes, now raise up your hand. Yes, Nishtha.
Ma'am, Anne thought that she could confide more in her diary than people, because she thought paper has more patience than people, as paper will not complain or interrupt her. Also, it will listen quietly and will keep all her secrets.
Yes, because she thought that paper has more patience than people. She knew that as people would complain and they would, you can say, they could present their views in a positive as well as in a negative manner, but paper would never reply back. They will absorb all the feelings that you will put into the diary. And this is the reason she thought that whatever the thing she is not, or she would not be able to discuss with other people or to confide in other people, she would confide in her diary and will discuss all the things in her diary. And this is actually, in which language this diary was written? Do you know? It was written in Dutch language. Later on, it was translated to English because she was German. She's a Jewish girl. Next comprehension question that is being displayed on your screen is, why does Anne provide a brief sketch of her life? Why before starting her diary, she has provided a brief sketch of her life. Yes, why she has provided a brief sketch of her life? Why does Anne provide a brief sketch of her life? Why she has started with that? Yes. Yes, give the answer. Don't mute yourself again and again. Yes.
Ma'am, Anne provided a brief sketch of life because she wanted to tell her daddy Kitty about herself. Moreover, she also thought that if anybody would be interested in her, he or she can also read about her life.
Yes. Yes. Why? Because she has provided a brief sketch of her life because she thought that if anybody would ever get the chance to read her diary, he should know that who is Anne Frank and what kind of life or what was her, what kind of life she was living and what she thought about herself. So it is just because of this reason that she has provided a brief sketch of her life. In that brief sketch of her life, she has explained about her father, Otto Frank, that when he was 35 years of age, he has married her mother, Edith Philander Frank, when she was just 26 years old. Later on, they have gone to Holland and they both were left at Ashen. This is some additional information just for your, you can say, revision I'm providing. Okay, so finally what happened, she has also explained about her Montessori nursery school, that what kind of relationship she was sharing with her principal, and when they were parting, there were tears in the eyes of both. And afterwards, she has also explained that she was too attached to her grandmother. So the next question is also related to the same thing. What tells you that Anne loved her grandmother? How can you say that Anne loved her grandmother? Yes, give a try to this answer. Yes. How can you say that Anne loved her grandmother? Yes, again the same student. Yes.
Ma'am, Anne told that she loved her grandmother because she had lived with her grandmother when her father moved to Holland. Moreover, when her grandmother passed away, she used to miss her often, and on his birthday, he lighted one extra candle on name of her grandmother.
Yes, because in 1942, when her grandmother fell ill, she did not have the celebration, or she skipped the celebration. She did not have much celebration of her birthday. And afterwards, in 1943, after the death of her grandmother, again when her birthday came, what she did, she just lit a candle in front of the portrait of her grandmother. And she has also specially mentioned in her diary that she is deeply in love and affection with her grandmother. Yes, Panchita, would you like to speak on this, for this question? Yes, Panchita. What happened? Okay, fine. Now coming up to the next ones. Now see here these question answers. Why was Mr. Keesing annoyed with Anne, and what did he ask her to do? So why Mr. Keesing was annoyed with her, Bhumika? Can you tell? Yes, Bhumika, speak out.
Ma'am, Mr. Keesing was annoyed with Annie because she was very talkative.
She was very talkative, yes. She was always talking in the process. Made Mr. Keesing annoyed.
And he punished her by giving her... He punished her by giving extra homework to write essays. To keep her silent, and the topics always related to her nature.
Yes. So what he has done, he has told her to write an essay on Chatterbox. Okay. He has given her essay 3 times to be written. First time he has told her to write an essay on Chatterbox. He has presented her that he has inherited the traits from her mother, and this is the reason why she's speaking a lot. Then afterwards, she was given again an essay to be written on incorrigible chatterbox, and again she has written 3 pages for it. And lastly, when she did not stop talking, and Mr. Keesing got so much annoyed, he has given her to write an essay, or he has given her an essay to be written on quack 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 chatterbox, right? And this finally she has written in a in verse. Yes. Next question is, how did Anne justify her being a chatterbox in her essay? So this I have already mentioned. Okay, so how she has justified her speaking? Okay, let me ask Nishtha again. Yes, Nishtha.
Being a clever student, Anne justified her being the chatterbox in her essay by saying that it is a trait of the student. Moreover, she said that he has inherited this trait from her mother.
Yes,
that she
absolutely
talk very well.
Okay, so she has justified, because when she was given the homework to write an essay, she has closed her notebook and went home, and after completing her homework, her eyesight got the attention of the extra work to be done, that is to write an essay on chatterbox. And she started to write, and when she started to write, she has written almost 3 pages for this essay, and she has mentioned that it is unavoidable trait of the students, that they speak a lot and moreover, why she is speaking more, she has inherited this trait from her mother, and this is the reason why she is speaking a lot in the class. So next question, do you think Mr. Keesing was a strict teacher? Do you think Mr. Keesing was a strict teacher? Yes, Bhumika will tell. Bhumika is raising up the hand. Yes, Bhumika. I have unmuted you. So what do you think? Just tell me yes or no. Was Mr. Keesing a strict teacher or no? Or not? Okay, Nishtha says he was a strict teacher. But okay, Nishtha, then how can you say that he was a strict teacher? Yes, Nishtha.
Now, Mr. Keesing wouldn't tolerate anybody speaking in the class, and when Anne was speaking and talking to her friends, he gave her a 1,000-word essay to write.
Okay, of course, we say that he was talking a lot she was talking a lot, that this is the reason why he did not tolerate has given her an extra work to write an essay on chatterbox. But in the end, when she has written that essay 3 times and finally she has took in a light-hearted manner, okay, he started laughing upon reading the poem, he laughed a lot, that when the duck, he has killed the 3 ducklings because they were quacking a lot, okay, and he has added on some personal comments and has shown or has read in the other classes too. So it means that he was not a so strict teacher. Okay, so ultimately at some point he also understand the feelings of the students, and he was well pacified means he was justified. Okay, or talking of Anne Frank, it was very well justified by her. So this is the reason why he admitted and he understood that this is an unavoidable trait of the students. Moreover, in the first essay also, when she has written that this is unavoidable or an inherited trait from her mother, as her mother speaks a lot, this is the reason why she speaks a lot in the class. So what this shows, this again shows that he understands he is easily carried up in the flow of the feelings of the students. He understands that why these students, they speak a lot. This is the reason why he was satisfied with the conditions or with the arguments presented by Anne Frank. But later on, when she did not stop talking, so then again he has given her an essay to be written. Next, what made Mr. Keesing allow Anne to talk in the class? Why he allowed Anne Frank to talk in the class? Why he allowed Anne Frank to talk in the class? So again, it is the same reason why he allowed, because in the first essay when she has written that this is an inherited trait which she has inherited from her mother, and because her mother talks a lot, this is the reason why she is talking a lot in the class. So this means that he has understood the feelings of Anne Frank. And moreover, in the third essay, which was written in verse form, in which she has explained about what she has explained about, she has explained about the male duck who has killed all the three ducklings because they were quacking a lot, they were talking a lot. So ultimately, he understood the feeling that the girl should not stop talking and the girl would not be able to stop talking. And ultimately, the relationship between Anne Frank and Mr. Keesing, it improved, and he allowed her to talk in the class, and she was never punished after that. Okay. So, coming up to thinking about the text, was Anne right when she said that the world would not be interested in the musings of a 13-year-old girl? So, what do you think? What do you say? Anne was right at this point. Anne Frank was right in saying this point that nobody should be trusted. Okay, Bhumika. Yes, speak out.
Ma'am, yes, Anne was right when she said so. Because most of children, because most of child's perspective toward the world, because they are too immature for the decisions they take. But Anne Frank has become one of the most discussed of all Holocaust victims. Her diary has been.
Okay, so let me explain because your voice was not so clear. So Anne was of course right in saying that the world would not be interested in the musings of a 13-year-old girl, because she knew that she was just 13-year-old, and when in 1942 she has started writing her diary, she knew that why should anybody be interested in the thinking of this so young girl. She thought herself to be immature. And she knew that nobody would be interested in the feelings of that young girl, and no one would be interested to know about what she thought, because she is too young to speak to write for that. So this is the reason why she has specially mentioned in her diary, in the starting of her diary, that no one would be interested in the musings of 13-year-old girl. But later on, she has presented all the feelings and all the, you can say, sufferings of the Holocaust, or all the sufferings in such a mature manner that this turned out to be an important record of Second World War. Or people, after reading it, they have come to know that what kind of life the people would be living in hiding. She has spent 2 years in the hiding, and two in hiding while living in annex, and ultimately it was really very difficult to survive there. But ultimately, because of the betrayal of one of the acquaintances, they have been dragged to the concentration camp, and where she died of typhus. She has handled her diary in a mature manner. She, in a simple manner, expressed her feelings, but those her feelings, they have turned out to be very important, or you can say very important in the point that they always displayed the reality of the sufferings of the Second World War. Okay. Next question. There are some examples of diary or journal entries in the before you read section. Compare these with Anne writes in her diary and what language was the diary originally written? Yes, this I have already asked you. That in which language was this diary actually written? It was actually written in Dutch language because she was living in German. She was a Jewish girl. And in what way is Anne's diary different? So how in the starting? In the starting, you can see let me share with you the page. You can see on the screen. Yes, see. So here, journal, okay? Journal, diary, log, and memoir. What is a journal? It is a book with a separate space or page for each day in which you write down your thoughts and feelings or what has happened on that day. Means one page for one thing. Diary is a full record of a journey, a period of time or an event written every day. But she has not written every day. She has in between written. So it's not a diary. Then what is a log? It's a record of a person's own life and experiences, usually a famous person. So it was not actually a log. Okay, because she was not so famous. She turned out to be famous after her death. Then what is a memoir? It is a written record of events with times, dates, usually official. So memoir is an official one. She was not an official girl. She was not working anywhere in which she has expressed. So ultimately, so it is a combination of all. Okay, of a journal, diary, log and memoir. Because at some of the points, why it turns out to be a memoir? Because officially after her death, this turns out to be official record of the sufferings of the people. Okay, so it turns out to be a log also because here in that she has expressed or she has written or she has recorded her own experiences as well experiences of life. Okay, she was famous after her death. Then diary. Of course, this is a journey. It was a period of life she has mentioned from 1942 till August 1944. And journal, we can say that because each page is devoted to one, you can say one date or one thought or feeling. But actually, she has not mentioned in that. Okay, she has combined it for a number of days. So ultimately, this is actually under one category. We cannot call it. And she was not so professional that she knew that what actually a diary is. So this is the reason it was a combination of journal, diary, log, as well as memoir. Okay. So this is all about the discussion of the question answers that we have to do today. So I hope that this question actually, it is related to the starting or description, which is given in the starting of the chapter, right? So till here we have to do. Now I have to take your attendance. If you have any doubts related to it, now you can raise up your hand so that I can take your doubts.